Welcome to Subramani. I have done two posts on why index funds and advantages of index funds. Having said that, one should also do the disadvantages of index funds or what are the limitations of index funds. So if you remember long back, the big critic of index funds used to be Parag Parikh, who said this is exactly what should not be happening, that everybody goes and buys one share, then everybody goes and sells one share. In fact, he has in his book on value investing, he has examples of how if you had invested in those shares which moved out of the index, you would have perhaps made more money than those shares which moved into the index. This is very simple because when everybody knows something, then obviously it is already built into the price. For example, you know that Axis Bank is going to be included in the index. All the people, all the active guys would go and buy Axis Bank and wait for the day then it goes into the index, and on that day they will sell because they know that internationally the big players like Vanguard or BlackRock or Tiger or Templeton, if they were running index funds or ETFs, they would be forced to buy. In the Indian context, it is SBI, all the NPS providers, HDFC, whoever runs big ETFs and big index funds would be the people who would be buying it anyway. They would be forced to buy because their mandate requires them to buy. So he used to be. Now let us look at some of the other risks which run while investing in an index fund. Am I contradicting myself by giving you the advantages and disadvantages? No. I think indexing has a lot of advantages, but it has its limitations too. And when I only tell you the advantages, I'm not being fair because very little of my own money is in index funds. It is there, but it is very small. It is insignificant. So I should also be telling you why I don't invest, and that is some of the risks which run. First of all, it is very crowded a market. Already in the US, more than 50% of the money is going into so-called passive. I'll tell you why I'm calling it so-called passive later on. But yeah, if everybody goes and buys the same set of shares, is there a chance that you will make money? If everybody thinks that you buy more and more of the same stuff, will you make money? Will you just conventionally, it is like buying land. Right, conventionally everybody thought, oh, land can never go down, therefore we should buy land. But now you have enough data to prove that land prices do go down, right? So there is consensus, just too many people. So it's a very, very crowded kind of a buying. So let's say, for example, 14% of the index is Reliance. It does not require any brain at all to know that all fund managers who are tracking Reliance will be forced to buy Reliance. So Reliance can only go up, right? Everybody has to buy Reliance. So only person who is betting against Reliance is the guy who is going short, and it requires tremendous guts to go short on a share which is 14% of the index, right? So the people going short are also scared. So Reliance can go only up till the day comes when everybody thinks Reliance is not a good buy and everybody sells, but on that day the index fund would still be buying. We recently saw that happening when Yes Bank was, nobody was buying Yes Bank except the index fund because it was there in the index. You're forced to buy. Maybe it is 1%, maybe it is 0.5%. But if you are in the index, people will have to buy. So on a day when Ramalinga Raju comes and says that there is a problem in Satyam or there's a fraud in Satyam, the only person still buying is the index fund, right? So you have to be careful about that, of too many people doing a crowded transaction. That obviously leads to the next one of valuation risk. What tells you whether Reliance is correctly valued, overvalued, undervalued? You have no clue, but you know that every month some 5,000 crores will go into Reliance because of the index funds and because of the funds which copy the index, right? And they close at index funds. So all these guys will keep on buying Reliance, immaterial of valuation. I'm not getting into whether it is overvalued or undervalued, but the fact that it is in the index and it is 14%, or Infosys, which is say 9% or 8%, or HDFC Twins, there will always be buying, and the guy wanting to go short on these shares would be pretty scared to go short simply because you know the avalanche of buying that is coming. So a fair price discovery is not really happening in case of shares which are there in the index. True in US, true in India. And one keeps wondering what happens if the market falls and a lot of people want redemption. Remember one thing, passive investing is what we are talking about. Does not mean that it is unemotional investing, because a person who has invested during good times in a good fund definitely sells during the market when the market comes down. Whatever you say about contrarian investing, staying on in the market when there is a fall, all that is true, but there will always be redemption. So when there is a redemption which is greater than the number of people investing, that time what will happen? Because there has been a consensus buying. Now if there is a consensus selling, what happens? Secondly, front running can definitely happen, because I know that tomorrow you will be forced to buy. So all I have to do is go and buy Reliance and wait for the index funds to buy it and take the price up. So such simple trades are available, and people will exploit it. There is nothing wrong in people exploiting it. That is the essence of why the market exists, right? So to that extent, there is this redemption risk. Then there is the risk of liquidity. What happens if there is not enough money coming in for you to buy? What happens if the size of the industry itself shrinks? Who will then buy when you want to sell, right? So the redemption risk and the liquidity. Redemption risk is when everybody comes to you and says, I want the money, and then the fund itself has liquidity risk because there is just not enough buyers and you have to sell at any price. Is this possible? Yes. When does it happen? It happens only in a falling market. India luckily has been having a longish bull market with intermittent corrections. During such times it is not visible. But if you take situations like 1929 or maybe even 2008, if there is a consensus trade that equities should be sold, there will be selling pressure on index funds too, and there will not be enough market to be buying it, because if the fresh money coming in is not greater than the amount which people want, then the markets will obviously come down. So people with lot of money who can do front running, who knows that the weight of this the index is going to change, or what is going to come in and what is going to go out, and these are all very clear, well drawn out rules, like market floating stock, impact cost has to be less, so much valuation has to be so much. I mean, buying Tesla and waiting for it to be included in the index was such a simple trade, because Tesla was too big, it was not profit making, it did not come in. But otherwise, convention demands that on the happening of certain events, a share will come into the index. So doing a front running on that does not seem to be very difficult at all. When there is no proper valuation done and you're buying it just because it is in the index, there's always the worry that there will be some permanent impairment to capital, and those shares could then be removed. Satyam was removed, but there was impairment to capital. But I would look at that as an advantage too, because if you were holding just Satyam, you would be hurt far more than while holding the index fund, because there is a self-correcting mechanism in the index, right? Then there is always momentum stocks. The good chance that if you have momentum stock, like Reliance currently looks more like a momentum stock and there is buying, that is bound to increase the weightage in the index, and more, it's a vicious circle of weightage increasing in the index and therefore more index funds going in and buying that, right? Then there is, because what happens for an active fund manager, he sits and considers whether the share is worth buying. That is not true in case of a conventional index fund. He just has to buy. So based on that, good valuation never comes into play, and the guy who has to go short doesn't have the guts to go short. So it is slightly distorting the market. I don't think that is something for us to worry about in India as yet, but US, the amount of money going into the index funds has dramatically gone up. I think it is crossed 55% now. With such huge amounts going into the index, the question is, who will buy when these fund managers want to sell? That's a difficult question. Thank you.